Hi everyone, this is Lahir from ABC's of Anaesthesia, and today we're going to go through ultrasound guided intravenous cannulation. Now this is exactly the technique that you want for the most difficult veins. Sometimes your veins are deep, sometimes you just don't have many options and you want to get it right first time. So what we're going to go through is a structure. You know how I love structures. This is going to be PPDFG, and that's the way you get the best settings and the best view of your vein. So let's get started. Let's get started. Now, I've got with me a very helpful volunteer, Kwan, and he's going to help us kind of demonstrate these techniques. So let's go through that framework. It's PPDFG, and that stands for probe, preset, depth, frequency or focus, and gain. So we're going to show you that now. So there's a couple of probes you could use, a hockey stick probe and a linear probe. Now, this one is high frequency, which means that you're going to have really good resolution, but not that much great depth resolution. And then you've got the linear probe, and this is, you know, slightly less frequency, which means you still get a pretty good resolution, but a bit more depth. Now, most of the time, you can really use either one of these. I pretty much go for this one most of the time straight away, but they're both very, very useful and very good. So what you find is that the frequency is already preset on these, which is pretty important. So when you choose the probe, sometimes the probe is chosen itself based on the probe that you've put into the machine. Other times you might have a button like this which you press and then you just preset. So you can either select one of these for what you're doing. So this is the linear probe in here. And now the next part is presets. Again, presets might be in a different menu, but really what it is I can choose a whole lot of different presets here based on what I might need. Now these presets are maybe different between different ultrasound machines, but they probably represent a preset algorithm to optimize your picture for whatever you need, whether it's nerve, vascular, carotid, superficial, whatever it is, it will optimize that image. So let's go for vascular. So that's probe, presets. The next thing we want to do is depth. I'm going to get my very helpful volunteer here just to put this on. And what you see is a number of different markings on the side there. These account for centimeter markings. So this depth is about 4 centimeters. Generally speaking, for ultrasound cannulation, I don't need more than 2 or 3 centimeters. So I can just decrease that depth. As you can see a whole bunch of structures here, including the artery there, which I'll show you in a second. The minimum depth is about, you know, 1.5 centimeters, which I rarely use that shallow a depth. And the maximum depth is around 28. And again, that's definitely not what I need for this particular ultrasound guided vascular access. So let's go to around 3 centimeters. That's probably perfect. That's D for depth. Next one is F for frequency. That's already preset. So some different machines may allow you to alter the frequency. Just know that higher frequency gives better resolution, but lower frequency gives you more penetration so you can get more definition of deeper structures. So you might want to play around with your settings to get the best view possible. F for focus is this little arrow. So there's usually some marking, and what you do is you move the arrow to the structure of interest. So because maybe I'm wanting to do an arterial cannulation, I'd move the structure up there and it makes that structure there the best resolution. Whereas if I had something deeper, I can move that down and it makes that area there better resolution, better quality image. So that's frequency and focus. Finally, let's go to gain. Gain is really how much information is coming back. It makes your signal brighter or darker. So increased gain really just makes the screen brighter. Decrease gain makes it blacker, and obviously you just need somewhere in between so that you can identify structures. So it's again a very useful setting to have. Okay, so I think that's pretty much it. We've gone through how to make your presets really effective. That's PPDFG, that is probe, presets, depth, frequency and focus, and gain. And that's all it is. I'm gonna show you veins on a live volunteer with ultrasound. And so it's gonna be really useful again for the most difficult veins, the deepest veins, and when you've got a lot of problems trying to get vascular access, the ultrasound is an absolute game changer in giving us extra success. So first of all, as always, I get all my setup as usual, but what I'm gonna do, I'm not gonna focus on all the details of cannulation, I'm just gonna show you the veins. So first of all, apply a tourniquet. Now what this does is it promotes arterial flow, it doesn't block the arterial flow to the arm, but it does prevent the venous flow going back, which increases the pressure in the veins, which means that they stand out and it's much easier than to show you stuff. So the first thing I do is I always check the orientation of the probe. So what I do here is I just touch here with a glove and make sure that I get some interference in the correct side so I know the orientation of this. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to scan. You'll see that veins are generally really superficial. I'm going to show you what we can see. I've got a vein here, but it's pretty superficial. So I'm just going to decrease the depth. And so what you can see is this hypoechoic structure or black structure. And it's, you know, it's elliptical, which means that it's probably some kind of vessel. And it's also very compressible. So you'll see that I'm just pressing down gently, and that is also compressing. And most importantly, it's not pulsatile. If this was an artery, it'd be pulsatile. Now let's compare it to another side over here. Okay, so I've got another structure. It's a bit deeper. And what do you notice about that? That's actually pulsating. And so that's an artery. Now, it is compressible, but the more you compress it, the more it's going to be pulsatile and it'll really show up there. So that's a structure that I don't want to use. I definitely don't want to get vascular access for if I'm trying to do an intravenous cannulation. So you've got to be very careful with that. If I was to put Doppler on this, you'd also see color pulsating through. And that shows you that it's likely to be a pulsatile structure as well. Beautiful. Now, interestingly, across here, we have the median nerve. So that little bundle there is a median nerve. So you can see that this whole cubital fossa region is, you know, there's a lot of things going on there. There's tendons, there's muscle bellies to the other side. There's this median nerve, which you definitely don't want to damage, and there's an artery. So when we're going for these cubital fossa veins, like this one here at the top, you've got to be really careful that you don't go very deep. Now, I find that ultrasound cannulation is just that such a really useful technique because it's told me a lot about the structures around and how I need to be careful. For example, that vein in the cubital fossa that we'd go for time and time again is really superficial. That's a 0.5 centimeter mark. And so this is, you know, from about 1 to 2 millimeters to 4 millimeters at its maximum depth. So if your cannula is going more than about that, you're probably too deep. And if you go too deep, guess what? You've got the artery there and you've got nerves there. Now, here's another interesting feature here, which is really great to see. You see these two structures. We've shown you the artery that's pulsatile, and I increase pressure and show that. But as I take the pressure off, you can see this beautiful big structure here, which is a vein. Now, that vein compresses while the artery next to it is pulsatile and doesn't compress as easily. And so very occasionally, when I've got the most difficult situations, I'll need to be very accurate with my intravenous cannula to make sure it goes into the vein and not the artery. So that's something quite interesting to note. So now, when I look down here, I've got generally the cephalic veins on the lateral side, basilic on the inside. And so, you know, when I was starting out, I was probably trying to aim more for the lateral veins because these ones here don't have as many, you know, critical structures like arteries and nerves below it. So that's probably a safer one to go for. Whereas when I come around here into the medial side, you've got your basilic veins, and you can see one at the top just there. But again, below that is a number of critical structures. So I'd say this side once you get a bit more comfortable and you're familiar with your needle and the depth. What we're going to do is a real life ultrasound guided intravenous cannula on a very helpful volunteer. So let's get started. So what I'm going to do is all my usual setup. So I'll put on the tourniquet, make sure my patient's comfortable. Obviously this setup is a bit different because we're using a trolley here. I'll use aseptic non-touch technique for all of my stuff. And I'm just using a small 22 gauge cannula. Then we clean the surface with a chlorhexidine alcohol solution, making sure the patient isn't allergic to these substances. And then we'll get started. Firstly, what I do is I just check my cannula and then just make sure that the tip is loosened. I then just check the ultrasound, make sure it's the right orientation, which it is there. And just have a look. I'm going for the lateral side because there's lots of other structures inside on the medial side that are a bit dangerous. And as you can see there, you can see the vein there. It's compressible and it's not pulsatile. So here we go. Sorry, Kwan, you're good? Beautiful. You can see on the screen. You can see that tip on the screen that's in the center. And so now I know I'm in the right spot there. I'm just going to advance it a little bit and then thread it through. And that's gone in nicely. I put my ultrasound probe down, loosen the tourniquet, put pressure distally over there, and make sure my sharp is nice and safe. And then I put the cap on like so, making sure that there's minimal blood coming back. And that's gone all really well. Put the tegaderm on. There, we're good to go. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna flush that and make sure that that's working. Thanks very much for watching, and tune in for more ultrasound-guided vascular access videos.